प्रणाम सद्गुरु जी, बेस्ट ऑन यूर इंटेंस इनसाइट्स ऑब्जर्वेशंस, डू यू फील नेटिव अमेरिकन कल्चर एंड देयर वे ऑफ लाइफ हैज एन कैपेसिटी टू ट्रांसमिट एंड इम्पार्ट देयर स्पिरिचुअल एंड कल्चरल एजुकेशन टू देयर नेक्स्ट जनरेशंस of their own people, as it is done well in our Gurukulas in India, including your own Gurukula in Coimbatore in our ashrama. I have another small question. There is a feeling or an assessment, or an assumption that the Western education and an aggressive teaching of their concepts, which they consider to be civilized Western ethos. Do you think that kind of education, that Western, civilized Western ethos, has really diluted or in fact even erased the identity, culture and the spiritual traditions of this Native Americans? Do you feel like that? And what is your assessment, in fact, I would like to ask you, on the role of different education system on the spiritual legacy of the population? And I would appreciate if you can address this question.
Namaskara, Surab Navre, Bala Santosha. Illi Naniga Utah Lidine. So your question about our Native American people imparting their culture, their spirituality and their form of life to the next generation. Yes, they are doing to some extent, but you know how the present culture, aggressive culture of the day, where completely ruled by economic concerns, is definitely seeping into everything. But above all, what we need to understand is, since 1890 or so, till 1978, it was illegal to practice any of the Native American spiritual rituals or whatever. So, largely people who could actually conduct these rituals and these processes kind of disappeared, very few were left. So, only since 1978, they can actually, you know, practice their spirituality, which is now coming up, but knowledgeable people, capable people are very scarce and they're trying to do their best. So when we say Native Americans, it's not all the same, because there are over, at one time there were over 500 tribes. Even today, distinctly, there are at least 100 to 120 tribes that we can easily recognize. So it is not all the same. Some tribes are a little better organized, some tribes are in a bad state. So this is not evenly divided, but they are doing their best to bring it back now. And there is also interest in the larger population in terms of general interest, because people read these things online and they're getting interested in it. It is very relevant because they lived so close to the land. Ecology or environmental sciences were not textbook stuff for them, it lived in their hearts. Because of that, it is very relevant for today's generation and tomorrow's generation also, because this needs to happen to the world, this needs to happen to the population, that we become a conscious planet. That is, ecology and the environmental sciences are not some abstract stuff, we must feel it in our hearts. So the Native American people, the uniqueness of them is, they did not live on this land, they are the land. They lived as a part of the land, so that aspect has to get to the world. That is one aspect that I am also trying to bring out. Well, education system was designed to take away the spiritual legacy of the Native American people, because at one point the whole generation of the Native American children were taken away from their parents and put in boarding schools where religious conversion happened, and they were not allowed to learn their own language. Once you cut off people from their language, they're completely cut off from their culture and spirituality. So it has been a systemic effort to take it away, it is not a certain impact. The modern education was a system to destroy the native culture, but still, fortunately, they've kept some part of it and they kept it alive in the reservations. Now that there is little more freedom for them, at least in legal terms, there is more freedom, though they're yet to achieve economic freedom. They have in… by constitution, they have all the rights that any citizen of United States has. Because of that, there is a possibility they can come back. And also in the general population, there's much more interest in exotic cultures. There is more interest in whatever is seen as exotic because people are exposed through… because of internet and other things, they're able to communicate with the world. Many youth leaders from Native American community are beginning to build a following in the online space. I think this is the way forward to bring back the culture to whatever extent we can. But all said and done, we cannot make history to live again. We can only remind ourselves, take a few valuable things from that and move on with modern life. That's how life is. Namaskara.